training programs. So the biggest news that I've got for you is the thing I didn't tell you when I was on last time. I was just trying to get myself back in the swing of vlogging and doing the thing. So I didn't go into any detail about this, but I've been waiting to show you Lydia's custom Plastidip and retro taping job. I took a couple weekends and worked with my dad deconstructing, coding, recoding. And then reassembling and adding tape. Weekends, four steps, really harrowing shit, like trying to figure out how to get it all taken apart safely. If you've never taken the fairings off your bike, you may not know exactly where the bolts are and where it's just got like rubber grommets that have pegs pushed through them that just hold with pressure. So, you know, not knowing that stuff, it can make it pretty challenging to get all that stuff taken apart. Even with diagrams and people's instructions off of YouTube, which is the kind of stuff we were trying to go for. So even with all that, we still found it was kind of a bitch. And had my dad cussing, and he doesn't usually like to cuss. So anyway, I'm gonna see if I can find myself a nice empty parking lot. And we are gonna park for a second and show her off. All right, there she is. Now here's the nice thing. Check that out. Hopefully the camera's getting that. That's what she looks like when the light hits her. So there it is, product of probably a good 8 to 12 hours, somewhere in there. The fairings, my dad was kind enough to replace the busted fairing on the right from that very first spill I took back in Rookie Mistakes, or that I described taking in Rookie Mistakes, link here. You can still see some of the scuffing and stuff that's left over. I mean, I still gotta do a little bit more. I'm gonna take the tailpipe back off and hit the whole thing with some high temp automotive black. But the shield's black. Windscreen, I think it looks a lot better like that. I mean, it's not functional anyway. I don't need it to be, you know, clear so that I can see through it. I was lazy enough not to take off the decals. So if you look real close, you can still see the Ninja logo at an angle there. I am already getting a little bit of scuffing on the Plastidip, which I expected. And honestly, I'll just hit some of those spots with it again if they need it. First time I got gas, the dude hands me the pump, and then before I can do anything with it, it blurps gas all over the side of my tank so I can see that. Like, I can tell where that was. And I tried to carefully blot at it, and it already picked a little bit of the Plastidip back up off of there, which I'm a little pissed about. I am intent on a few more modifications here. So like I said, I'm gonna hit the tail with some more black to cover up the scuffing and also get that whole end looking nice. And I'm also gonna get myself some tech spec tank grips for the side and here, where my pants are already picking a little bit of it back off.
So I'm gonna get some grips for the tank. But otherwise, the plastic dip's looking pretty damn good. And I'm really fucking happy with this. I think this looks great. The other thing that I have yet to do is I gotta get myself some of the extenders for the mirrors. Right now, a common complaint with the Ninja 300 is that the position of the mirrors, you see your elbows. Like, basically, you just get a whole bunch of arm right in your mirror, unless you tuck your elbow in real tight. And that's true. At least it's true for me. So I will be getting myself some 1-inch mirror extenders that push them up and out, and that gets a little bit of extra width on them, and then you can change the angle a little bit. So otherwise, she is looking good. This is 1 year into riding, as of today, in fact. And I am so happy with how this is all turning out. I'm done recording. Thanks for checking out this bike reveal. I'm gonna get off the Tuesday night coffee. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.